We might just move on then to our final speaker for this session. So Lillian KP is the Senior Technical Advisor for Health Programs and Lead for Non-Communicable Disease Interventions with the International Rescue Committee. She's been a public health practitioner for over 20 years and has extensive experience in different contexts. Thanks.
Thank you. So I'm going to give a brief presentation on IRC's work on NCDs, which is quite young, given that we've been focusing mostly on communicable diseases up to now. So the IRC, these are the contexts we work in. Our US program is really big because that's where IRC started several years ago with bringing refugees from Europe to America resettlement program during the Second World War. And now we've expanded into an international program, and you can see how a lot of our work is in the conflict zones. And basically our work is health, education, protection, safety related work, economic recovery and development, as well as governance and rights related work. So in terms of NCDs, the context that we work in currently are really ranging from refugee settings in Kenya, Chad and Thailand, to displaced population settings in Somalia and urban settings in the Syria response region. And our teams in Europe are also seeing migrants passing through with NCDs. A lot of the work we do is integrated within primary health care programs. Oops, sorry. What did I do? So I wanted to show this to show that very little is known about the burden of NCDs in the context we work in. Especially in the low-income countries like Chad, Kenya, and Thailand, and more is known in terms of the middle-income countries. And yet we're also aware that a lot of these are moving populations, and we need to be conscious of the fact that we should prioritize varying models of care depending on the context. This graph actually raises more questions than answers. We analyzed data for 2015 from 5 countries. This is NCD data that we could get. And basically, we saw that hypertension is the most common NCD. We are not sure whether this is, okay, we are sure that this is not because of the high burden of hypertension, but because this is the illness that's most commonly diagnosed within the clinics, hypertension and diabetes, that is. And then in terms of Thailand, because they do screening every year, they have high cases of hypertension diagnosed during the screening sessions. In Jordan, we found that 33% of primary healthcare consultations are NCDs, and over 60% of these are women. So in terms of the challenges we're finding in our young NCD program, insecurity is a big thing. As we all know, healthcare is being targeted, and we have examples of clinics and healthcare centers having been bombed and access to care affected as such. Border closures, so we have cross-border programs in Turkey, Iraq, and Jordan working into Syria. And border closures, as well as reduced access to the teams within those contexts, means that patients have periods when access to drugs and supplies is limited. And so what we've been doing is trying to work with teams within Syria and working through partnerships to ensure continuity of care. Referrals, especially for complications and terminal illness, is also an issue. In terms of systems, so we realize that we need to be better at kind of estimating how much drugs and supplies we need for our programs. But how can we do this when we don't know the burden of disease? And in terms of human resources, capacity of staff to do the trainings is a big issue. We know that trainings ensure that programs are cohesive, and our staff turnover in the areas we work in has meant that NCD management is not always done the way that it should be, and quality of care is reduced as a result of this. And so we're looking at ways in which we can have a continuous training of staff. How do we make sure that we have TOTs in these places? In Jordan, what we've done is train people from within Syria as TOTs so that they can go back and continue with these trainings. Health information systems, as has been mentioned repeatedly this morning, is an issue. So we need to revise the health information systems with more focus to NCDs. Record systems, this affects adherence a lot, adherence and continuity of care, but also follow-up of patients and follow-up in terms of outcomes, but also in terms of individual patients. This is an example from Dadaab where we have paper-based systems. So in terms of individual level challenges, so there's limited knowledge about NCDs among communities we serve. And generally, this affects ability to effect positive lifestyle changes. But we're also seeing a situation where, how do you talk about diet and exercise when there's no safe access? And also, how do you talk about diet when people don't have access to other options? And so one of the things we're looking at is linking health and cash, where in our emergency programs, we're looking at cash distribution, but also ensuring that our economic recovery programs are linked with our NCD programs. So there's also market to ensure that people have access to these healthy food options. Self-monitoring and self-care is not well established. So in some of our programs, for example, in Dadaab, we have community health workers monitoring at community level blood pressure and blood sugar, but this is not systematically done, and also it's not well monitored. Adherence to treatment, as I mentioned earlier, remains an issue, especially because we're not really able to follow up if people are adhering to treatment at the moment. Secondly, we have patients moving from clinic to clinic and shopping for the providers they prefer. And so this remains an issue as well. Community level work, we're not really integrating NCDs within our community health strategies, and there's limited resources for community engagement around NCDs. So one of the things we are talking about is how do we learn from examples of other chronic diseases like HIV and TB management at community level. So I was happy to hear Helen's presentation on that. So what are we doing? We're bringing together these countries that have identified NCDs as a priority to review the state of prevention, treatment, and guidelines for NCD control, and also linking with the efforts of the NCDs in humanitarian crisis working group that's led by UNHCR, so that this is done in a cohesive way. We've developed a theory of change that I'll talk about briefly later to guide the program design and implementation, and also working systematically to improve supply chains. On the prevention side, we realize that we need to harmonize routine and outcome data across countries to enable public health actions, and also think about community prevalence and risk factors. And on the emergency side, including NCDs on rapid assessments and establishing systems for regular supply of medicines and diagnostics in this context. So this diagram is our theory of change. It's a bit difficult to read, but it's on the website and it's free for public use. It comes along with indicator lists and measurement guides as well. And basically it has two arms. So we have the prevention health promotion arm and then the treatment diagnostic arm. And basically, in terms of prevention and health promotion, we're looking at people having the resources to prevent and treat NCDs, and people having the skills needed. So this is linking with education, whereas the resources links with our economic recovery programs. And then having an enabling community environment that enables people to adopt and practice preventive behaviors. And then people having the motivation as well. On the clinical management stabilization side, we're looking at people having demand, so creating demand for these services, and also making sure services are equally accessible for vulnerable people as well as women and men, and services being of good quality, so establishing quality control and monitoring of this on a regular basis. We realize that there's almost no evidence on NCDs, especially in humanitarian crisis, and one of the things we're doing is trying to define a research agenda, and these are the seven main areas we're looking at. We're working with people from various agencies and academic institutions to come up with a list of questions that can be answered. And this also is linked to the operational research we're trying to do. For example, in Jordan, we're trying to see if mHealth could be an option, and linking communities with community health workers and patients using CompCare, for example. So in brief, that's what I had.